excuse me, first place.
This is Calvin Kastein. We're at the Lake Champlain Bluegrass Festival. It's approaching 2 p.m. on a bright and beautiful Saturday afternoon, August 13th, 2005. And they're just handing out the winners of the annual fiddle and banjo contest that took place from 9:30 till moments ago. Hundreds of people are seated around here awaiting the start of the paid acts. Look at the folks that are here. A beautiful sight here in Alberg, Vermont, about a mile or so from the Rouse's Point Bridge, the Veterans Memorial Bridge. So if you're coming in from the New York State side, you don't have to cross on the ferry. Follow the lake and come across the toll-free bridge. And this is the fourth annual. We were here. There's Kim LePan and Chuck enjoying the event.
And the winner of the senior division, Don Perkins.
Donnie Perkins is a winner here. Well, we've known he's a winner for a long time, though. Plan on this next year.
Hurry up, Don! Hurry up!
Part of a day.
Run. Here we go.
Man, 66 years old. Give him a break. We're awaiting the start of the Abrams Brothers, and we're going to be bringing you at least part of what they have to offer. We've heard they were very good, and we want to get a little bit of them. So we're going to do that right after they finish handing out the awards. So we'll be coming right back. Don't go away, because we won't. The young Abrams Brothers have made their way on the stage along with the group. I imagine their father is one of those folks out there. And we just don't have a place to get in front of the bandstand because of this huge crowd. We just have to be blocking out about 40 people if we stood somewhere in front. So we'll have to side view will have to suffice, and I hope we can get a good enough view. It looks like we'll have a pretty good angle. We'll have a guide wire in front of us, but outside of that, we should have a pretty good angle on the group.
Ontario, the Abram Brothers!
From Kingston, Ontario.
Thank you. Yeah, a little bit of Jerusalem Bridge.
A couple of Finland brothers.
Well, folks, you've been a wonderful audience, and we're sure sorry that we can't hang around with you for the rest of the day because we know there's a lot of great music coming, but we have really enjoyed our time that we've been here.
Yeah.
And could we come back sometime? Yeah. All right.
Jen Gage Medley, son.
We're doing an old gospel number right now. This is on the boys' debut release on Master Shield Records out of Bridgewater, Virginia. It's called Carrying On, the CD, and that's currently for sale over the internet. It's for sale right here, too. If you're interested in it, you can get it right here. This is called I'm Gonna Talk It All Over With Him. Ready, boys? One, two, three. Pretty well on Prime Cuts. It's an old song that Bob Dylan recorded many, many years ago. It's called The Gospel Plow. Ready, boys? One, two, three.
Gospel, and I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Keep your head.
Well, folks, the next song that the boys are going to do, they always dedicate it to the memory of a great brother duo, Jim and Jesse. Of course, Jim passed away in 2003, and Jesse is still with us, and he has been a very great supporter of the boys' music. And we have the privilege of riding down the highway in their old bus with all the memories and all the greats that have played on there, Mr. Monroe and the Stanley Brothers and you name it, they played on that bus. And it's really neat, underneath the bumps, there are notes written by different people that played on that bus, and so it's a living piece of history. So this song always goes up to Jim and Jesse, and I'll let John introduce it for you.
This song, James and I learned a couple months ago off of the Sing, Sing, Sing album that Jim and Jesse released, and it's called Glory to His Name. We're going to try and do it right.
And at the cross where I see your God, and my poor planting from sin I cry. There to my heart was the Son of God. Glory to His name.
Over too. quickly who we are for those folks who have not seen us. Has anybody here not seen us yet? Well, there's a few over there. We still got some CDs left, folks. Come on over. Over here on the guitar from Gananoque, Ontario, Mr. Bob Burks. Give him a big hand, please. From Nashville, Tennessee, on the old five string, Mr. Craig Morris. The number one generation of the three generations in this band on the Doghouse bass, my dad, Mr. Wayne Abrams. 12 years of age, fiddle player, mandolin player, banjo player, big upright bass player, Mr. James Abrams. 14 years of age, mandolin, guitar, fiddle, and he plays the dobro too, Mr. John Abrams.
Playing rhythm, guitar, singing lead, and harmony vocals, he's my dad, Brian Abrams. Give him a big hand. This next song we're going to do was written and recorded by Travis Tritt in 1995. Who all is a big fan of Travis Tritt?
Yeah, bluegrass crowd.
This is a bluegrass crowd. Well, he's bluegrass too.
He can play bluegrass.
That's right. This song is called Recorno Bro, and it was done by the Grassos recently in a kind of a more bluegrass form, so we're going to do it our way. There you go.
As we sit out on the front porch of that old gray house where I was born and raised, staring at the dusty fields where my family worked hard every day. Well, I think of that burden when I say, Daddy, there's a love that I don't know. But don't you ever dream about a life you're going to go.
Our times are real, it's just a dream.
street now. Boys and Phil and the old five string are going to come out here and do something for you. You know, back before they had all kinds of guitars and bass fiddles and mandolins, the fiddle and the five string was what there was. And this is an old Irish tune, actually. The boys were working it up on the bus on the way down here yesterday. It's called Cold Frosty Morning. Make the boys feel welcome, would you please?
Somebody heard us in Thomas Point Beach doing this one. And Wayne and I were in church together, but our wives were there. But there was a sermon, and Wayne wrote this song in a few minutes on a program at the church. And I think it's a great song. You give it a listen.
We named it, the preacher referred to, our pastor back home, referred to the 12 disciples as the Motley Crew. Now, I don't want you to get confused with the, there's the folks back there. You know, I thought when I was writing this song, the pastor was speaking about, you know, when Jesus was looking for somebody to go with him, he didn't go to the religious establishment of the day, folks. He picked ordinary men, and in those 12 men, you'll see every kind of a person that's in the world today. So I think there's something important in this song. Listen to the words of Motley Crue. As Jesus walked beside the sea, he said, Peter, come follow me, and Brother Andrew, I want you then to make your fishing now for men. The next to join were James and Johnny, men of strength he came upon from casting nets upon the sea, their lives now spent to set men free. And what they grew, they looked like the wind, they waved their nets to fish for men. Their work on earth had just begun to fall in the Father's Son. Loud and clear, the Son of God, you are now near. He healed the sick and he raised the dead, striving Pharisees and said, Son of God he claimed to be, but his works and good they could not see. A mighty crew they looked like when they left their nets to fish for men. Their work on earth had just begun to follow him, the Father's Son. To teach and set men free, each one would show in his own way the traits of man we see today. And even one close by his side with bitterly when he denied, he knew the one who owned that day was Shepherd Cain all the way. A motley crew they looked like when they left their nets to fish for men. Their work on earth had just begun to follow him, the Father's Son. Now the last verse, folks, is about poor old Judas. You know, if it hadn't been for Judas, there wouldn't have been no Calvary. And if it hadn't been for Calvary, there'd be no Easter, and there'd be no plan of salvation. So Judas is a pretty important ingredient in this the whole thing. One of the crew he could not trust, but for the sinful man it was a must. Coins of silver Judas paid a point priced out on that sad day. The coins they gave he must return filled with remorse when he did learn the one he loved. They would tie to a cruel cross where he would die. A motley crew they looked like when they left the next to fish for men. Their work on earth had just begun to follow him, the Father's Son. To follow him, the Father's Son. Every summer, and they're supposed to be there helping me work, but we do an awful lot of picking. And we worked up a few songs together, and we had this one worked out with Jamesy on the bass. There we are. We got a little, I'll tell you folks, Carter Stanley is the songwriter, where it's at for me. And he wrote this one here. I think Jimmy Martin got a lot of mileage out of it too. It's called I Cry It Again. I
gathering the thing that might have been. And bow my head in pride again.
Time, and we're just so happy that we could be here for the time that we were. I want to say right now, thanks again to Steve and all the organizers here. This is a wonderful festival. They're doing a wonderful thing here. Big hand for all the folks that work here, please. All the volunteers who put in hours. This doesn't happen the week before the show, I can tell you that. We're doing a gospel number now, and we won't be here tomorrow, so we'll do a gospel number for you. Maybe neither will anybody else, I don't know. This is called Seven Sundays in a Row. Ready, boys?
Seven Sundays in a row has been.
Thank you. Hogan. The Ingram Brothers. We'd like to have them come back for an encore, but we can't do it because they have to be on the road. They've got another show tonight, and it's going to be tight. So thank God they were here. They made fantastic music. These guys are great.
Abrams Brothers at the 2005 Lake Champlain Bluegrass Festival.
First of all, any of the
bringing the bus out through here, sir?
As soon as we get, as they get the sound set up,
we were going to pack up and leave, but they got a little fiddling contest to wrap up, and we're going to stick around and do that because I think our buddy Donnie Perkins is involved. Abrams boys are trying to catch the bus here. The bus is going to leave without them. Nice job by those 12 and 14-year-old boys.
Off of the burn-off, or the tiebreaker, or whatever you want to call it, for the trick and fancy. So the first contestant is Don Perkins.
All right, I'm going to try a tune called Dragon Ball. Thank you.
Peter Miller, we're going to take just a real quick minute and draw the 50-50.
Oh, we're not done yet. There's another one. Melody Oakman.
Right around the back. Go right around the back. Right
a three-way tie, apparently.
Well, I'm back. I'm going to play another couple of tunes for you.
Thank you.
that's the end of the fiddling contest. Thanks for watching.
We'll let you know.
Hometown Cable at the 2005 Bluegrass Festival. Lake Champlain Bluegrass Festival. Beautiful downtown Albert. Thanks for watching.
Give the girls a time to tally the score.